it's your girl April. So what's up divas? You know what it is, it's already Wednesday, so of course it's Real Talk Wednesday. And before I even get started, the reason why I've got this wrap in my head again is because one of the young ladies from last week's Real Talk wanted to know how to wrap an eternity scarf around her head. So I said I would wear it again, so that way I can show you girls real quick on my Real Talk. But before I even get started, today's drink, it is in a purple cup, and I decided to bring it upstairs and show you girls. Normally I'll have like a flavored vodka with just regular orange juice. So today I decided to do the pineapple Amsterdam vodka. And also along with it, no orange juice, but the Jose Cuervo's, the original margarita mix in mango. So this stuff is like absolutely good. Just add Jose Cuervo tequila. Now, as far as mixing it, like making a margarita, you really don't have to. This contains 0% juice. It doesn't have any type of alcohol in it, I don't think, because I wasn't carded for this, but I was for the actual alcohol. So there isn't any type of alcohol in this, but I will tell you girls this, even if you ain't making no damn margarita, it tastes good with just the vodka and this. And it doesn't have to be this flavor. I started drinking it with the lime flavor, and I decided to try the mango today. It was on sale for $6.49 at my local grocery store, and it does say non-alcoholic mix. There are some which do have alcohol in it, and those are like double the price, like $13. So I didn't need the alcohol in it. I just wanted a flavored juice, and it's really, really good. It kind of works a lot better than the orange juice because, you know, orange juice is thick. So over time, your throat, it gets stuck in your throat. It's all thick in your throat, whatever. I'm really not going to go into all that, but yes. So let's get on to how to wrap this eternity scarf. And if my hair looks a mess underneath, don't say nothing. So, okay, so it's not because it's braided. So this is an eternity scarf, and an eternity scarf is basically a never-ending scarf. There is no end. Now, it is not this thick. It is thin. It's actually this wide. So if you have an eternity scarf, and I'm not sure if all of them are this wide, and you see here, it's super wide. What I do is I'll just take it, and I'll fold it in half. So I'll gather the sides, and I'll just fold it in half and just go around and fold it in half. So that way I have half of the width. You don't want it so big. And so being that this one here, I do have other eternity scarves that are not this great in stretchy material. It doesn't really matter if it's stretchy or not. But I like the ones with certain type of material. So this is more like, I would say this is kind of like a t-shirt type material, because it's so stretchy. I got it brand new at the thrift store with the tag still attached from Old Navy's for $1.99. And at Old Navy, I think it was like 10 or 15 bucks, whatever. I did have great intentions of wearing it as an eternity scarf around my neck, but yeah, forget that. It doesn't get cold enough out here for me. So what I do is I take the edge that's folded. So when I say that, there's the open part where you've already folded. Take those edges and put them to the back. I'll take this folded portion, and I'll hold it like so, and I'll just put it on my head like that. So now you see I have it like this. You can do it a different way, whatever makes you comfortable. And then I'll take it, and it covers basically majority of all my hair in the back area. You want to make sure that it's laying flat. It doesn't have to be perfect. You'll take this side, and you'll take this side, and you'll pull it as tight or taut as possible, and you'll cross them over. And now you have them both in your hands like this. Take it and just flip it over your head, and just take the straps and kind of like roll them like in a little kind of twist, and then you bring them together. You can still roll them. I like to roll them because it gives it a little bit of fashion. And depending on where you want the knot to be, you take it, and I'm going to put it right here, and I'm going to cross them over, and I'm just going to start twisting them like I was twisting hair. Just like if I was twisting hair. And that'll also roll them. And if you're worried about, well, what about the end? Don't worry about the end. You're going to tuck it in. So as you see, I'm just twisting it. And because I've twisted it so much, it kind of twists itself. So now I have a twist. And I'll take it, move it up a little bit. I'll wrap it around one time. And sometimes I like it to be right here. And I'll take that. And with the material that's in the back, I'll just cover it up. And there you go. It stays like that all day. And you don't have to do the knot around. You could just pull it back. Sometimes I won't do the knot. So I'll have it just like this. It'll just be twisted. And I'll do it like that. But today I want the knot. So I'm just going to do it like that. And you only need it one time around. And see, sometimes my knot comes out different depending on how I twisted it. Or you could twist it again. But I don't really like to have like a unicorn on my head sometimes. So, yeah. So you can either twist it going this way. And there. And it actually stays all day like that. And I think it has a lot to do with the material, the fabric. The thicker the fabric, the better the actual scarf will be full and it'll look better. If it's really thin, it's not going to look as good. So just keep that in mind. It can be any type of fabric, but the thinner the fabric, it's not going to be like a nice bunchy, but not like that in the front. So yes. Mm-hmm. Other than that, really nothing has been going on. I do have new videos. I have a drugstore edition makeup video that is already posted. It was posted yesterday. And prior to that, there was an AliExpress, Beauty Zone, not AliExpress, but it is an international hair company. So make sure you girls check that out because the video is live and super affordable hair. And yeah, that's about it. So if you want a real talk video featuring yourself, or someone you know, you can go ahead and always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. And please put in the subject line, Real Talk. If you have already changed the names of your characters or person in the video, please make sure to include that in like the first sentence. So that way I know that it's changed. But other than that, you can go ahead and do that. If you want a custom wig made by yours truly, or an in-stock wig, you can always visit my website at goingwiththewindwigs.webly.com. A lot of times, a lot of my wigs are sold out because I do keep the prices low enough to where they're affordable. And they're just basically not one of a kind because I can recreate the same look. But I'll probably put up more wigs within the week, hopefully. I'm finishing one now. I had 5 up 2 days ago, and I only have 1 left, which is a U-part wig, which is absolutely gorgeous. And I will be putting up a water wave full closure unit this week. Hopefully by Thursday, I'll have it up. Maybe Wednesday, but we'll see. But other than that, yeah, that's about it. If you're wondering about my eye makeup for today, I'm absolutely loving it, okay? First of all, it's all cheap makeup, not except for my foundation. The eyeshadow is actually Milani's eyeshadow. And the brown that I used to make the color pop, I used a smudge pop by e.l.f., which is like a paint pot by MAC, but an e.l.f., and it worked out so well. So I have like these brown sparkly eyes and I'm loving it. For those of you who love neutral looks, if you want me to recreate this look for a video with this eyeshadow, which is really inexpensive, everything that I use, even to the eyeliner, is inexpensive, then let me know and I will post a video up for you girls. Just put it in the description, not the description, but the comment section, that you want to see a video on this look. But I try to keep it really inexpensive. I do like to splurge on makeup as well, but I like to do both high-end and inexpensive makeup because I like both. It doesn't matter. Just like with hair, I like it all. Synthetic, human hair, it does not matter. I like it all because hair is an accessory. So yes, you girls, other than that, let's get on to this Real Talk video, okay? So okay, so that's better. I went ahead and fixed the settings on my camera because I was kind of looking yellowish. So now you can really see the eyeshadow colors. So really pretty. I really like it. So let's start. I'm thinking she changed the names. She must have. Okay. And what's so cool about this one is she broke it down from year dates, which is super easy. 2011, my boyfriend Joshua and I began dating. We were together almost 1 year when we had sex for the first time. Neither one of us had ever had sex before. 2012, Joshua went to foster care at the age of 16. I missed him so much I cried every day. When I wasn't crying, I was depressed. I constantly counted down the days until he came back home to me. 2013, Joshua is still in foster care at age 17. Still missing him, still crying every day. Still depressed when I'm not crying. Still constantly counting down the days until he'll come back home to me. 2014, Joshua comes home from foster care at age 18. I'm so happy. XOXOXO. 2015, Joshua is now 19 and I'm 18. I found out I was pregnant. 2016, I had severe back pain to the point of crying, and Joshua wouldn't massage my back. When Joshua did massage my back, he would huff and puff. When Joshua did massage my back, he would do it for a short period of time. Joshua made me hate going to the baby doctor, OBGYN, because I envied the couples that were there. I seen a guy massaging his girlfriend's back in the doctor's office, and I could rarely get Joshua to massage my back at home. Joshua would rarely talk to our daughter while she was in my stomach. Joshua made me hate going to the baby doctors because I envied the couples that were there. I seen a guy talking to his girlfriend's stomach in the doctor's office, and I could rarely get Joshua to talk to our daughter when she was in my stomach when we were at home, like I mentioned. I gave birth to our daughter on January 14th, a cesarean section. I was in a lot of pain. I heard cesarean sections hurt, but I didn't know it would be that painful. Joshua complained because he had to put on my coat and shoes when I wanted to go out and smoke a cigarette. This was after her cesarean, not while she was pregnant. He specifically said, I hate dressing you. I hated that he had to dress me too. On January 24th, my mom took me to the emergency room because my cesarean section was leaking a liquid with a foul odor. I was told cesarean sections would leak liquid, but it would only leak a little and stop, leak a little and stop. Unfortunately, mine was leaking liquid in large amounts, and it was continuous. I thought it was an infection that would be cured with an antibiotic, but I was wrong. I quickly found out there was an abscess in my lower abdomen that would have to be removed with surgery. Right then, all I wanted was Joshua. My mom went to pick Joshua up and brought him to the hospital. Joshua complained he hadn't showered and he wanted to go home. Apparently, he thinks I want to be here. I watched the time fly by until it was close to time for my surgery. I was so scared. I looked at Joshua and said, Joshua, honey, I'm scared. Will you hold my hand, please? Joshua should have already been holding my hand. When I asked Joshua to hold my hand, he looked at me, so I knew he heard me. If he didn't hear me, he would have said, huh, or what? Joshua looked at me and continued eating and watching Netflix. Literally right after Joshua continued eating and watching Netflix, the nurse came in and said they were going to wheel me down to prep me for surgery. I called my mom to tell her they are going to go ahead and wheel me down to surgery. When Joshua asked if he could hold my hand, I turned and said, no, my mom can hold my hand. Not only was I hurt, but angry, severely angry. My mom and Joshua came down to see me before I went in for surgery. My mom held my hand. Joshua and I broke up shortly after my second surgery because I was hurt and I was angry. After the surgery and I healed, Joshua rarely came to see his daughter and still rarely comes to see his daughter. Now he's just being a butthole. because we rarely talk and he constantly isolates himself. Please help. Sincerely, we're gonna call Tabitha. So, Tabitha has been with this boy since 2011. All right, before then, 2010. Because 2011 made the year mark of them being together and they finally had sex with each other. Not saying finally, but you guys know what I mean. They had sex. They were both virgins when they both had sex, which was a beautiful thing. Even though they was both young, it still is a beautiful thing. Now, Joshua ended up going into foster care. A couple years go by, he finally comes home. She finds out she's pregnant. Joshua's not holding her hand. He's not rubbing her back while she's pregnant, massaging her. He's not talking to her belly. And Tabitha is seeing all these type of things going on with other couples while she's visiting the OBGYN for her doctor's appointments. And it's making her envy these couples. Seems like to me, not only that, but she had to go in and get an abscess removed from her stomach, from her lower abdomen after her cesarean section. Josh was kind of being like inconsiderate, eating, watching Netflix, not really too concerned about how Tabitha is feeling, what she's going through. But Tabitha is really asking for more attention. You know what I'm saying? Like, she wants Joshua to do this, and she wants Joshua to do that. She sees what she sees with other couples, other families, and she wants Joshua to be that way. She's not happy. What should she do? They don't speak. He rarely comes to see his daughter. He isolates himself. Well, this one I'm gonna tell you what. First of all, Tabitha, I could feel you on that because I have had seven in total. One was an abortion when I was 16, and eight, right? I got five kids, eight in total. One was an abortion when I was 16, five that I've actually carried, and two that I had a miscarriage with. Okay, so here's the thing. I can totally feel where you're coming from when you go into the OBGYN and you're seeing these other couples and they all lovey-dovey and he's doing this and he's doing that. I can totally feel you on that because when my first pregnancy, the only person that was at the OBGYN with me was my mom, okay? I was 18 or just turned 18 when I had my first kid, so I was 17. And of course, my kid's father was not with me at the time because I got pregnant in Pennsylvania while living with my dad for a couple of years. And I came home to be with my mom while I was pregnant. So the only person that was with me was my actual mom. And of course, she's not going to sit there and hold my hand and massage my back. And she might could do that. She has. Or talk to my stomach. And you know what? I'm wrong. My mother has done all of those things while I was pregnant with her first grandchild. However, that's my mom. And I could feel you because you want the same thing in return. And I can relate to that as in this. Before I got back into a relationship, and I was alone out here, and I've been alone many times before that when I used to be married and he would be in jail. I was alone many times. I was a single mom many times, okay? Regardless if I was married or not, he was in jail. So I was considered a single mom. And I could totally relate to that with you. Because I would go out in public, even while I was living here alone, and that wasn't in a relationship, I would go out into public and I would see all these couples just in Walmart holding hands, the boyfriend or the husband rubbing her butt and giving her a kiss on the cheek and with their kids. Trust and believe, bitches. A bitch was really upset and jealous and envious of what I was seeing. Because here I am alone wherever I was fucking at. And I wanted the same things too. You know what I'm saying? That's what I come and tell y'all. It's okay to be alone for a certain period of time. Because we need to grow as a person, as within ourselves. You know what I mean? But sometimes being alone for so long can really get to you. So it did start getting to me. And I would see these couples and I would say to myself, why can't I have that? Why can't that be me? I wish I had that. I'm a good person. I'm a loving person. Why can't I be given the right opportunity with the right person who will love me and hold my hand in public and walk with me through Walmart and rub my butt in public and kiss me on the cheek in public? Why can't I have that? You know what I'm saying? And these are things that I wanted for the longest. And seeing that in public, it does kind of bother you if you're in a relationship that's not like that, or if you're not in a relationship and you want to be loved. It does bother you. But here's the thing. Even when you're in a relationship, some people are not like those that you see on TV or those that you see in public. Because you see somebody else's man rubbing their belly and talking to their belly and massaging them, don't mean that your man gotta do that shit. And it's unfortunate. I'm not making excuses for them and saying, well, this is how it is. But that's really how the fuck it is. What we see somebody else going through and going and doing does not have to be necessarily our lives. Because behind closed doors, you really don't know what the fuck these people are going through. Yeah, he could be putting on a good ass front and show, massaging her back and shoulders in public at the baby doctor's, and rubbing her belly and talking to it at the baby doctor. But behind closed door, this nigga is a motherfucking fuck up, okay? A real asshole, a butthole, like you put it, okay? A really butthole. But like I said, non-purpose Negroes, okay? Negro, non-purpose motherfucking man, all right? He could be like that. So what you see all the time ain't what you fucking get. Just like with your boyfriend, Joshua. What you seen was not what you really fucking got. And over time, people change and they grow out with it, grow out of each other. And some things that you may be comfortable with as a person, he may not just be comfortable with. I'm going to use myself for an example. And sometimes I need to get over certain fears. And it's not even fears, it's just like certain things. I see a lot of these lookbooks and fashion videos on YouTube, and these young ladies are wherever. They're outside, and I'm pretty sure they're outside on the public street. There are people walking by, and they're staring at you while you're video recording yourself, or who's ever video recording you, modeling this outfit of the day. Now, me personally, I'm very leery like that. I really don't like people giving me too much attention and staring at me in public. So when I do my lookbooks, it's mainly in my room because I feel comfortable. Excuse me, my lashes got stuck together. I feel comfortable and I know nobody is giving me these weird gawky looks or just not looking at me in general. Now here's another situation. I got some items from a vendor on one of those websites who want me to model their clothes in a video. I'm all for it. I, of course, want to be in my comfort zone and model them in my room. However, where I live at in Avondale, Arizona, is beautiful. There's lakes in my subdivision, ponds, ducks, beautiful greenery. The scenery is absolutely gorgeous. Why won't I go to one of those paths and be video recorded? So I asked my man, listen, I want you to video record me with one of the outfits on, and it'll take me a couple of days to do all four of these outfits, but I want to do this outside because I want something different. He's like, all right, okay, it's good, because this is where he runs at. Every morning he goes out and runs, and I'm like, listen, babe, though, are there a lot of people? Because I don't want nobody looking at me. I don't want people gawking at me. I don't want nobody looking at me. He just looks at me like I'm crazy, like, are you serious? You do videos, you're on internet, and you're worried about people looking at you. It's a big difference to me, okay? Because I'm not really good in public with people staring at me and shit like that. When I see people approach me, I've had lots of people out here approach me, and sometimes they'd be like, oh, you're Muffin, it's my lovers. You know what? I'd be like, no, I'm not. But then I'd be like, okay, well, just chill. Yes, I am just messing with you. Because I'm not really good with a lot of publicity. I don't like people staring at me. I don't like to be approached sometimes because I'm a very, even though you see me on camera and I cuss up a storm and I'm doing videos, remember, I am behind the camera. And though I'm a very social person and I'm the most friendliest, down-to-earth, chill person, being around a lot of people sometimes makes me a little nervous. And having people just watch me out in public while I'm doing a video makes me a whole lot of fucking nervous. So, that being said, what you see Tabitha, other couples doing and other men doing, your boyfriend may not just feel comfortable doing that in the public eye. However, you did say in your home as well. So, if he's not feeling comfortable in public, and he's still not feeling comfortable at home, then he has an issue with himself. And just like you said, he isolates himself. he doesn't, if he isolates himself, that means he keeps to himself. He doesn't bother with other people. He's just to himself. And a lot of people are like that. I can say for myself that I'm somewhat like that because I don't have a lot of friends. I don't really like to go out a lot where there's a lot of people in public or a lot of people with... I just really don't. I don't like to be noticed too much. I just kind of like to blend in. And some people have a fear of if they do something, they are going to be ridiculed for or they're going to be looked at a certain way. Now, I'm not making excuses for him, but this might just be his issue. However, the fact of the matter is, he was kind of rude about the whole situation when you was about to go into surgery and the motherfucker just sat there and ate and watched Netflix. Let's get this straight. First of all, I'm in here about to have surgery. You can be a lot more compassionate than sitting there watching Netflix. There's really no time for watching Netflix. You're supposed to be consoling me. I'm not saying kiss my ass, brown nose with me. I'm not saying do none of that shit, okay? But what I am saying is you are supposed to be consoling me and making me feel like I am an importance to you because first off, we've been in a relationship for like 6 years. Second off, I carried your child. And third off, because I had a cesarean section and all of this shit, now I've got an abscess. So let's look back onto the past and see where this all started from. Show some fucking compassion and consideration. However, some men and even some women are just not so emotionally inclined like that. I'm gonna be the first to admit that I'm not. And it's kind of fucked up because I'm a female and we're supposed to be so much more emotional and I have kids. When it comes to my kids, I'm emotional with them to a certain extent. Like, I just don't really care for kids crying out loud. Like, ooh, 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 I can't take that. You can cry loud. You can cry quietly. You know, I don't need to hear you crying. Toughen up. So I'm kind of like that. But when it comes to, like, relationships, and I don't know if it's because I've had a bad relationship. Not all of it was bad, but it started to get bad. But I don't know if it's because I had a bad relationship, because if it wasn't that bad, I would never got divorced. But I don't know if it's because I had a bad relationship, and that's why I'm like this. But sometimes it's hard for me to express my emotions to you without exploding. You know what I'm saying? I can talk with you and have a great conversation, but sometimes I keep it bottled in and I'm not so emotionally inclined to where you could be sitting there to me talking about how much I love you, crying, and I just want to be with you, and I could care less. You know what I'm saying? I could be like, well, I love you too. My emotions don't be in it like that. And it's not that I do it on purpose. It's just the type of person that I am. And maybe it has a lot to do with the things that I've been through. But you gotta see, he's not gonna be the person that you want him to be. If he ain't been the person you want him to be, sweetheart, Tabitha, he ain't gonna be the person you want him to be. You cannot change a person, though we all would fucking like to change people and make them into the person we want. Hallelujah to that, okay? Because if I had my fucking way, trust me, there'll be a lot of motherfuckers running around here who were changed on April's decision and what the fuck I want them to be and how I want them to be and how I want them to fucking act. They would be just that way, okay? But it's not gonna happen. He is who he is. And even though if you guys can't see eye to eye, the main key is this motherfucker needs to spend time with his child and be a parent and stop isolating himself. Because that's not the child's fault, and it really ain't your fault neither. But here's the main key. You cannot force nobody to be who the fuck you want them to be. They're going to be who they want to be regardless. And you either going to leave them the fuck alone and let them come around on their own terms, or leave them the fuck alone and let them come around on your terms. Now, if it were my way, you would come around on my terms, because I'm not about to let you just walk in and feel like you got it like that and you could come and go when you please, because it don't work like that in the real world. However, let him be him. Ain't no time for ass kissing. He ain't gonna change. He is who he is. He's not gonna be that emotional person that you expect him to be. If that's what you're looking for, baby, you're not getting it from him, because you've already been there. And it's time to move the fuck on. You young, you got your whole life ahead of you, you got a beautiful child with him. Regardless if he wants to come along and be in that child's life or not, that's on his decision. But here's my one number one purpose, my number one thing. Never tell your child that their parent is a piece of shit, okay? Don't go bashing the father or the mother to the child, because in the long run, your child is going to be able to see all that shit circumference. You know what I'm saying? Your child is going to see that for themselves. And I say this because my dad and me, my mom and my dad, they divorced when I was 10. But they were separated since I was like 3. My mom moved back to New York from Pennsylvania. And I would go every summer to stay with my godparents, who was also my father's aunt in Pennsylvania. I didn't stay with my father, he lived there, but I stayed with my godparents for the entire summer. And I would go over from time to time and stay with my dad for like a couple of days. Wasn't an everyday basis, but it was from time to time. I didn't see him like I should have seen him, but I seen him. Now, my mom would talk about my dad to me as a kid growing up, and I never will forget. She would say things like, you know, your dad is a big child, all he wants to do is play with race cards, smoke weed, and things like that. He's this, he's that, he don't do nothing for you. You know, just basically just tearing him down. And as I got older, of course, I grew to hate him because of the things that she would say about him. So when my mom sent me to live with him when I was 16 because me and her weren't getting along, it was like, oh, you gonna send me to this motherfucker's house and I don't barely even speak to him and he's got 2 other kids that live with him, which is my brothers, but you gonna go send me over there. So of course I had animosity and I had a whole lot of bitterness inside of me. And living there with him, my 2 brothers, which were both from 2 different women, second wife, third wife, which was currently living with him, the third wife, I felt bitter. My stepmother, she was a great person, but she would tear my father down too when he wasn't around to me, and I was 16 years old. She would talk shit about him like he wasn't shit. And of course, I'm gonna go along with her because I've already been dealt that hand from my mom. You know what I'm saying? So as I got older, when I say older, in like my 30s, me and my dad became really close. And I realized he might not have been the best person for you at 100%, but he's a damn good father to me. So I say this because if your boyfriend Tabitha don't come around, Joshua ain't coming around to your daughter, don't go bashing him to her. You know what I'm saying? Because you can fuck a kid's head up mentally and to the utmost with that shit. They gonna eventually see on their own. Just like with my 13-year-old daughter. My ex-husband don't call my 2 kids, Johnny and Mumsy. He don't call them. The last time he spoke to them was a year ago for my daughter's birthday, April 30th. Johnny's birthday. We should be 14 this coming Saturday, I think the 30th is on. That's the last time he spoke to them verbally over the phone. He ain't sent them shit for holidays. He ain't said nothing. Not a goddamn thing. Not a letter, nothing, a postcard, nothing. And it's kind of fucked up because those are my kids. Mumsy's 8 and she really don't care for him because of the things that she's seen in our past, you know, arguing and fighting. So she doesn't care for him. She actually calls him a maniac. And I didn't have to tell her anything different about her father. It's what she's seen on her own. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm not with that bashing. My daughter, Nay, who's 13, about to be 14, she can't stand him. She says, I hate John, because that's what she calls him. And Jamel is my dad, meaning my fiance, which is my 17-year-old son's father, because he's always there for her and he's been there for her for the longest. So you don't really have to tell your kids nothing about their fathers if they're not coming around or if they're not doing what they're supposed to. They will grow up and they will see this on their own. And so I just tell you that, so that way just let your child live a healthy life. And as for Joshua, let him be him and let him do him. If he doesn't want to come around, then that's his loss, not yours. And it's his loss on the kids. It might be the kids' loss a little bit. However, as a parent, we have to be 2 sometimes. And there's nothing wrong with that because that's what we built for. So let Tabitha know your thoughts on that. I say walk away from him and leave him the fuck alone. Seriously. Okay. So So let's get on to the next one. Hi, April. I just subscribed to your channel literally today. This was April 8th, this email. So happy that I found you. You are the realest of the real, love. I love your personality, raw and very uncut. I'm going to try my best to make this email short, but this situation, I must warn you right now, it is crazy as hell. Call me Vanessa, and my baby father name can be Los. Okay, here it goes. I just had a baby 5 months ago, and unfortunately, I am a single mom. My son was a miracle because I thought I could not conceive at all. Then I met Los about 2 years ago, and he just instantly took my breath away. I was very attracted to him, and he just knew how to hold a conversation. I had gotten out of a relationship 3 months prior, so I wasn't really looking. And so me and him took it rather slow and decided after 6 months to make it official. We experienced a lot of wonderful but magical things together that shocked his family along with some of my friends. And I think that despite us having the terrible falling out that we did, now that we will never forget those beautiful and unbelievable experiences. So I tried conceiving before but had a few miscarriages, but when Los came along, it just happened naturally and we both were shocked. However, Los had other kids from a previous relationship, and it was okay with me because I felt that this is his kids, and they were not a big issue at all, and I knew that he took care of them, and that is what made me fall in love with him more and more, because I felt that he was responsible, and he was all about family first. I met his family and everything, and I felt like, wow, this relationship is going to work, and I was very happy with him. We did everything together, church, bars, concerts, you name it. He was like my best friend. When things got rough for him, I would give him money and just be there for him. However, things went left. He wouldn't allow me to be his friend on social media after I had met his family and everything, and he had proposed to me. And I broke up with him because of it, because I felt like he had something to hide. But of course, he begged me back, and I took him back. We did the breakup and makeup cycle throughout the course of our relationship. Then one day, I popped up pregnant, and it was crazy because me and him were intimate, but he started acting distant. So I decided to part ways for good. Then I found out I was pregnant and started having complications due to being stressed about the breakup and almost lost my son. I told him about it, and he called me at the emergency room and then hung up, and I didn't hear from him for 3 months. I had my son prematurely and almost died due to stress. He was never there during my pregnancy or for the delivery of our child. He lied and said he was out of town, that he got into some trouble. Come to find out, his family didn't want him around because they all hated me and he just didn't want to be around. Sad thing is, despite all he put me through, I didn't put him on child support because I wanted him to come around and do for my son on his own without the courts involved. And I still haven't put him on child support at this moment. I found him on social media and saw photos of him with his other kids, but he never once saw my son, our son. He just would call and text to check on him, but would never show up like I wanted him to. I exposed him on social media and told his family about our son because I believe he was keeping him a secret. And he sent me a message stating that I was a secret and not our son because his family hated me and that he should have never dealt with me. He then blocked me on social media. I feel so stupid and my heart is hurting so bad because this was not the same guy I met 2 years ago. I know we had issues, but I tried to correct them, but it was just not working. And then my son looks so much like him, and I feel bad because I know that he will not be around him. I was okay with us not being together, but all I wanted for him to do was be a father to his son, like he is for his other kids. I called his mother a bitch on social media because she hated me from the beginning, and she is a poor excuse for a grandmother. Strangely enough, she didn't block, nor did the people I tagged in the photo. Shaking my head. I just wish things would have never turned out like this. Also, I found his baby mother as well page on social media, and I tagged her in the post I wrote of me exposing him, and she was petty enough to like the status. It was just a crazy situation, but I had to expose him. I'm starting to believe he did not want her to know I had a kid with him, because he must have had plans to get back with her, even though she was in a relationship, and I believe that hurt him really bad that she moved on. By me exposing him messed up his plans of getting back with her, maybe. I don't know what is going on, I am just speculating. They have a history, so anything could be possible. He sent me a text message saying that he wants nothing to do with me and that he will regret not being part of his son's life. He took away my whole experience of enjoying my pregnancy, and I became so depressed after having my son. I felt so alone and miserable. Was I crazy for calling his mom a bitch and exposing him? I have never gotten out of character like this, but this situation has taken a toll on me, and this is a big life-changing event to a child that you thought you couldn't have to only get carried in the end by a man who said he once loved you. I have since shut down my social media page because it just reminds me of all the chaos, and I'd rather not deal with it. Some people told me to reopen it to prove him and his family that I'm fine without him, and I don't have time for that tit for tat. But I don't have time for that tit for tat. Please let me know. Please let me know. But I had so much pain and hurt built up that I reached my breaking point. He put me through hell, and I feel like he is out enjoying life while I'm stressing and trying to pick up the pieces to all of this while raising my son on my own. I don't need any money from him because I have a great job. All I wanted was for him to be a father. Sorry for the long email. It's a very intense situation. I'm going through. It's more to the story, but it kind of sums it up. Thank you in advance. So, let's get back to her name. Vanessa and Los. Now that was long, but it was good. So basically, Vanessa had quite a few miscarriages, didn't think she could conceive a child. She got with Los. They had a baby together. She met his family. He started acting all flaky. He proposed to her, but he wasn't her friend on social media. And she didn't like that because she felt like he had something to hide, so she broke up with him. He begged her back. They got back together. Yada, yada, yada. They break up. They make up. This goes on throughout the cycle of the relationship. He has yet to see their 5-month-old son. He will text and call and check on him, but has yet to see him. She has went ahead and exposed his ass on social media about the baby, called his mother a bitch, tagged his baby mother in the photo, and she said that his baby mother, Los's baby mother, was kind of petty because she liked the status. Well, here's the thing. You really can't say he's petty because you exposed him. So that was kind of being petty too. You know what I'm saying? You can't get mad. What did you expect her to say? What did you expect Los's baby mother to say? Did you want her to say something or like the status? Either way, she saw it, so it is what it is. She feels like he's out enjoying his life while she got to pick up the pieces and be a single mother. Let me tell you something. Vanessa, is that what it is? Yes, Vanessa. Ain't no peaches and cream in being a parent, and ain't no peaches and cream in any type of relationship, whether you married or single or just dating, whether you're pregnant or not. People think a lot of times because they have these fucking babies, excuse me because I said fucking babies, because babies are a blessing, but people think a lot of times because they have these babies that they're going to keep the man, that's going to make the man stay. No, bitches, sometimes that'll make their asses run even further and quicker, but either here nor there, you got to continue on with your life. So what? He out enjoying his life. I got 5 kids, okay? To 3 baby daddies, all right? Remember I said that in one of my videos? 5 kids to 3 baby daddies. All right, 3? No, excuse me. 5 kids to 4 baby daddies, right? Yes, 4 baby daddies. So I have 5 to 4, okay? Let's just get it like that. Something like that. I know 2 of my kids got to involve. Okay, anyway. You really think that I give a fuck if they out enjoying their life? I'm not about to let no non-purpose Negro, non-purpose man, spoil my life and time with my child. You sitting around being miserable and stressed out and depressed, you giving him and his so-called family exactly what they wanted. So was it petty for you to call his mother a bitch on social media? I'm not going to say it was petty, but it was kind of disrespectful. Even if they don't fucking like you, you don't have to stoop to their level. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we got to be a little classy about our shit and do what's best for us. Not try to expose people. Yeah, it's wrong that his family don't like you. I don't really know the reason why his family don't like you. He just says they don't like you. What could possibly be the reason? Because you met them. you seem like you was getting along with them and you met them and what happened? Regardless, who gives a fuck if his mother don't like you? My ex-husband's mother don't like me and his sister don't like me. Remember I said we was fucking throwing blows and shit. I don't really give a fuck. I don't care if my fiance's family don't like me. I'm not here for you. I'm not here for you. I'm not here for you. I'm here for this motherfucker. And if he don't like me, then that's where the problem starts. But if you don't fucking like me, I could give two fucks. Okay? So was it petty? It wasn't petty, but it made you and your character look fucking stupid. Never stoop down to nobody else's level. If they don't fucking like you, if they don't respect you, leave them people the fuck alone. Never go on no type of social media and put no dumb shit up there, because that's the type of shit that you cannot take back. Whether you delete it and remove it from internet or social media, somebody else got a copy of that shit. A screenshot, a download, or upload, they have a copy of it. So never fucking make yourself look stupid on no social media. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to say this because I have done that, where I've said in a video on my prior channel how I had to fight my husband and beat the shit out of him because he was drunk. And I took that video down. Now, I don't know if somebody downloaded it or uploaded it from YouTube. I could get two fucks. However, I'm just saying this to you. Who gives a shit if his mother and his family don't like you? You ain't fucking them. You ain't there for them. But you ain't fucking this motherfucker neither. And he don't want to come around his kids. Let me tell you something. So what? He enjoying his life. Bitch, don't never let nobody else tear you the fuck down and make you not enjoy life, okay? Because for one, like I say this all the damn time, life is too short. And I ain't about to let nobody, man, woman, cat, dog, duck, bird, whatever, ruin my fucking feng shui, my day, and my vibe. You're not about to make my fucking life stressful with your bullshit because you miserable. You know what I'm saying? So if he enjoying life, that's good for him. Let him take care of his other kids and enjoy his fucking life. You know what I'm saying? But you got a son with him, enjoy your fucking life with your kid. Don't sit around moping and be depressed and stressed out over some nigga that don't fucking want you. You know what I'm saying? The key word, he don't want you. And his family don't neither. However, your baby got you and your family. And that's all that fucking matters. Do you really think you see my last two kids, Janae and Mumsy, Janae and Janaya, her grandmother from their father's side, that bitch don't call me. That bitch don't write. That bitch don't fucking social media text me or whatever you want to fucking call it and ask about her grandkids. She could care less. And do you really think for one fucking second that I give a fuck if that bitch do or don't? I don't give a fuck. I would prefer you not to say a motherfucking thing to me or my kids. But I'm not about to tell my kids that. But if you don't fucking call, you don't check up on them or none of that, that's your loss, not my kids' loss. Because when they grow up and they continue on with life, they're going to see what type of people you are. And they ain't going to want to fucks with you. So if they don't want to be bothered with you or your kid, fuck him. And if that nigga don't want to come around and see his kid and all he want to do is text, and call, fuck him too. Here's the thing. You can't continue to be so stupid, Vanessa. And I'm saying this because of this. As long as you continue to respond to his text messages and his phone calls, that's all that Negro gonna do. Okay? Here's my thing. The next time that motherfucker texts you about his son, bitch, please, don't fucking respond to that fucking text message. Because if you really want to be a baby father and you really want to be a father and daddy to your child, then you will get off your high horse and come see him. Until then, I don't have no words for you. I'm pretty sure he know where you live at, okay? And until he knock on your motherfucking door, I would not respond to a text message, nor would I respond to a phone call. If that nigga is calling and saying, I'm on my way over to see the baby, well, listen, if you don't answer, he either gonna come over or not. And if he don't, that's his fucking loss. But as long as you keep going back and forth with him through text message, oh, yeah, he's good. Oh, he's walking now. Yeah, he's holding his own bottle. Oh, he was sick. Then as long as you allow that, he gonna continue to do that. Let me tell you something. I don't play those text games. I don't play those phone games. If me and you got an issue, we gonna handle this as grown folks in person. I'm not gonna go back and forth texting you, arguing with you on the phone, arguing with you. If you don't fucking like me, I don't give a fuck. But I'm not going to argue back and forth with you on the phone and text messaging on social media. Because here's the thing. When you see a bitch, then you see a bitch. And this is how I am with everybody. I really don't give a fuck. If you want to argue with me in social media, bitches, you know where the fuck I be's at. I'm right here in Arizona. And if you see me in public, then address me. Until then, go ahead and write all that dumb shit on my text, social. I don't give a fuck. But when I see you in public, best believe it's going to be on and popping. Ain't nobody got time for texting back and forth. As long as you allow that nigga to continuously text you and ask you how your kid is, as 5 months old and hasn't come over and yet to acknowledge him, then he's gonna continue to do that. You doing him a fucking favor. You giving him alternatives and options and shit like that. Fuck a nigga, okay? And fuck a bitch too, alright? But I'm not about to give you all these options. That is not being a parenting texting. Motherfuckers today think that texting, that's their whole world, texting. Like, bitch, you can call me on the phone. I'm not gonna sit here and waste my fucking thumbs and energy texting you back and forth. If you wanna call, that's cool. Better yet, won't you drag your raggedy, lazy ass over here and see your 5-month-old? But if he cannot do that, bitch, please stop responding to his text messages, okay? As long as you continuously respond, then he's gonna continuously do the same dumb shit. And if you don't respond and that nigga don't never come around and see your son, then oh fucking well, okay? The person that's gonna hurt because of it might just be him, the baby father, and it might just be your son. Either way, your child is going to know that you are the parent and that you were the one that was taking care of him. And you and your family was the one for him there all the time, not your baby father's family. And it hurts to say this because sometimes you have to let a child see and know these things on their own. Never good to bash a person. Never good to bash a parent, another parent. As though we may like to and want to sometimes, leave it the fuck alone, because a child is going to realize that sooner or fucking later. You know what I'm saying? On some real shit, they will see that. And as far as the child support, you don't want to bring it to the courts because you want him to give it to you on your own. Girlfriend, honey, child, please, hunty, I feel you on that. Because that's the same way I feel. Like I said, my daughters, they don't get anything. And he doesn't give them anything, okay? Now, I could be a bitch, and not even a bitch, but I could just be me and take you to court. But here's the thing. I'm not even going to waste my time. Because if you can't willingly, like a parent and a responsible, loving father, take care of your kids, then nigga, I don't want nothing from you. I don't really feel like I should have to force you to do something through the courts. You know what I'm saying? That's just not me. If you don't want to do it, then fuck out of here. Fuck out of here. Because my kids gonna already know this is what I do. Some motherfuckers like to say, well, I pay child support, so fucking what? You pay child support. Okay, big fucking deal. But that don't mean shit. Some think that because they pay child support, that they doing the whole world a big fucking favor. Okay, big fucking deal. You pay child support. But what else do? You give money, but you don't give time and effort and love and none of that shit. So it really don't count for much. However, I want some new shit right about now. I've been thinking high and dry about this shit to myself. Like, listen, April, you done came and brought your kids all the way to the other side of the world to give them a better life. While this nigga is running around drunk again, got arrested again. Yes, I found this all out through the internet. And you're having a good old party while your kids, they ain't wanting for nothing. But it's sad. Don't you think you have a motherfucking responsibility? Because it would be wrong of me to just say, fuck these kids and get up and go, and then they would have nothing. But I can't do that because I'm their mother, and that's not the type of person I am. So I've been thinking high and dry, long and short, about getting some child support. And a part of me is only doing it because I want to be deceitful. Because I'm going to let you know, nigga, don't fuck with me. And sometimes, I'm sorry to say, bitches, but we got to let the motherfuckers know, nigga, don't fuck with me, okay? Because I'm the last motherfucker you want to fuck with. And I'm just saying, so even though my kids don't need it, I've been thinking about taking your ass to court and getting some child support. Because you know what? I'll take all that money and put it in the bank for them. And when they old enough and they grow up, they can move out and they'll have enough to buy themselves a car. Or maybe, I don't know. But whatever. You know what I'm saying? But It's fucked up when you gotta bring other people, judges and lawyers, into a situation to take care of your kid that you have in common with this person. That's fucked up. Like, where do we do this at? Be a responsible human being and take care of your fucking kids. We should not have to bring nobody else into the situation. You know what I'm saying? Just take care of your kid. Anyway, Vanessa, it was petty and it was someone was petty. Here's the thing about social media. Social media will fuck up your life and have you fucked up, literally fucked up as a person. You know what I'm saying? I got like a drop in here. I'm going to pour this shit in. It will have you fucked up as a person. A lot of people stay on Instagram and stay on Facebook all day long. Like, they're getting paid for that shit. And I really, as a person, don't understand how and why. I don't be on Facebook like that because I don't really find it of much interest. You know what I do? My shit, I will post shit on Facebook, but it will be about a wig for sale. Or whatever I post on Facebook will come straight from Instagram. I'm not really a social media person. I don't want to scroll through pages and pages of people's pictures and selfies all day like. I don't really give a fuck about all of that shit. It's not interest to me. Instagram is okay. It's good for publicizing things, for business-wise. But I do. Sometimes I do look through it. Not like that, though. Some people, all they do is all day long on Facebook. I'm still trying to figure out, how the fuck does one sit on Facebook all day? Like, do you guys understand that shit? Like, it's really not that interesting to me. Like, I don't know. Maybe I'm just a totally different person. I really don't give a fuck about social media like that. You know, like Snapchat. People are like, why don't you get a Snapchat? And I have to ask my daughter, what is a Snapchat? Okay, I'm 42 years old. Yes, I've been on YouTube for a minute. But I'm like, what is a Snapchat? She has to tell me, oh, it's like a story. She didn't explain this to me like 5 times. It's like you show movies or some shit like that. I don't really know. I'm like, man, I don't even have time for that. I don't barely fucking have time to be posting pictures on Instagram. Now you want me to do a Snapchat? Like, man, please. I don't really need y'all in my fucking business like that all the time. You know what I'm saying? Like, some things are just better kept to themselves. Like, some people really get into all that social media. I just don't have time for all that. I got a life to live. Like, I don't really want y'all all up in my business all the time. Not to say the least, and I'm not being rude, but I'm just really not intrigued with all that social media like that. Like, yeah, you may find some good info on social media, but some people take that ride or die, like die hard. So here's my thing, Vanessa. If you don't want to open up your social media accounts again, then fucking don't. Who gives a shit about it? Life is still going to continue on. However, if you do, don't get on there exposing people and acting shady and doing dumb shit. Take pictures and post them of you and your son. And if his family and he so happen to see it, then that's their business. But don't post it out there to be on some tit-for-tat shit. Post it out there because it's for you and your son. And these are memorable moments. And also, don't let nobody tell you or let you feel like he's enjoying life and you can't. Let me tell you this. You got a 5-month-old. When they're babies and when they're little like this, these are the most memorable moments. You are going to enjoy life more than he is, okay? With that baby, you are going to have a grand time. And I tell you this because I have 5 and I have 2 grandkids. 2 grandsons. And my last grandson, he is 1. He's over 1. He's a little bit over 1. But it's amazing to me because I was the one there who cut his umbilical cord. I was the one there to see my daughter's whole stuff. And I seen him come out. Me. I was the first face that he saw when he came out. And it's amazing to me because I have seen him from a tiny little thing to this little boy who's over 1, walking all over the place, calling me mum mum. I'm not even Gigi anymore. I'm mum mum. I was Gigi to my first grandson. But to him, I'm mum mum. And I'm his world. Like, he thinks everything of me. And I so adore the hell out of him. Like, you know what I'm saying? I love the hell out of him. But it's amazing because he's over 1 and he walks, and I call him Happy Feet. I nicknamed him Tinky Man. Everybody calls him Tinky Man. But I'm now starting to call him Happy Feet because he can walk and he looks at his feet and he's like, oh my God, they can do this. And I call him Happy Feet and I spoil him rotten. And it's just amazing because you see them when they're just this little coming out of you. And then they blossom into young men and young women. So fuck him if he's enjoying life. Bitch, enjoy your life too with your kid. And take him out and let him see the world and explain things to him. But don't bash his father, because he will see this on his own. Okay? So on to the next, Vanessa. Let Vanessa know what you think about that one. Now this one here, let's see. It ain't that long. Okay, this is the last one. Hey, April, I'm a new subscriber and I love your channel. And I'm asking your advice because you always keep it real. You can call me Renee, and I am 24 years old and have been living on my own since I got my first hospital job at age 19. Before then, I was living with my parents who got divorced when I was 18. The divorce was messy. My dad cheated on my mom for a long time, and when she found out they got divorced, after the divorce, my dad changed his number and did not give me his new number. My mom said it was okay to have a relationship with him, but I wasn't able to because he changed his phone number. So after a while, I just stopped trying. I was very hurt and confused. One day, 5 years later after the divorce, I run into my dad on public transportation. We exchanged numbers. He wanted to hang out, but I was still upset and wasn't ready. So after a few months texting back and forth, a couple more run-ins on the train, I decided to meet with my father. At the dinner, I tell my dad how hard it is living on my own. Since I moved out so young, I made a lot of mistakes, like moving out without any savings. I was eager to move out because living with just my mom after divorce was driving me crazy. My father gave me a little money, and a couple days later, he texts me to see if I want to move in with him for free. Right now, I pay $900 a month for my studio. Turns out, he is now married to the person he cheated on my mother with. I agreed to meet her too, since I figured it would happen regardless since they are married. And it turns out, me and my stepmom really click, although I didn't think I would. I always blamed her, my stepmom, as well as my father for the messy divorce, but we still clicked and she brought up me moving in again. At first I thought absolutely not. It would be a betrayal to my mother who worked so hard to keep herself afloat after the divorce, as well as helping me time to time. At one point, I did move back in with my mom for a short period of time and paid her $400 a month until I found a new place. However, recently, due to issues with the new car I bought and other bills that I have piled up, I am starting to think maybe it would be a good idea to take my dad up on his offer. His wife has two sons that are my age and are now moved out. So I know she wouldn't be strict and give me a curfew because she didn't for her sons. But even if she did, it would still be worth it to be able to save money. I waited 3 weeks just to mention anything to my mom. And when I finally got the courage to tell her that I was thinking about moving with my dad, she did not take the news well. Her reaction was, so after disappearing for 6 years, he gets to come back and be the hero? I told her, I didn't feel that way, but I understand why she would be hurt. In the end, she said the decision would ultimately be mine. It breaks my heart to know that I am hurting my mother's feelings, but at the same time, the financial break can really help me in the long run. What should I do? Okay. Here's the thing. It's the same fucking scenario. It ain't even the same scenario. Okay. Here's the thing. Like I said, me and my dad, we were not the best of friends only because my mom, you know what I'm saying, because of things that she told me. So of course, you know, she told me, that's your parent. You believe everything they say. You believe in them as a person. But me and my mom, when I moved out here to Arizona, my mom been knew I started speaking to my dad on the phone. She would have little smart things to say, and I would not pay them any attention. So prior to me coming to Arizona, you know, making that long 4-day drive, I stayed with my dad for a couple of weeks. With my dad and my stepmom, because it's his fourth wife. And she is a Philippine woman named Norma. Now mind you, me and my mom don't always see eye to eye, and I have 5 kids. But it's something about when you have grandkids, you call and you check on them, you know, you should know their birth dates, at least, I would think, and you should know their names. I'm not saying I have a lot of kids where you shouldn't remember their names, but I would think that you would remember their names. Either here nor there, when my mom found out that I was there with my dad for a couple weeks. She had a fit too. She not a fit, but she did not like it. Oh, you went to see him. You couldn't come see me. First of all, I have 5 kids and a dog, and you live in an apartment. You don't want everybody in your house like that, and you're not very welcoming, okay? Second of all, what's the big fucking deal? You've seen my kids many a times. Not many a times, but enough times. And my father, who I've been estranged from, he's never ever met my kids. He will call and talk to my kids all the time on the phone, but he's never seen them in person, except for my first kid. So we became so close, me and my dad. And it sucks because as much as my mom raised me, I love my father to death. Me and him have like this totally different relationship than different from my mom. And she gets upset, you know what I'm saying? So I don't even mention it to her anymore because she always has something negative to say. And I'm 42 years old in June. I don't really feel like hearing negative shit that you have to say. You know what I'm saying? Grow the fuck up. This was like how long ago? But what we have going on, me and my dad, is like genuine. And I'm happy that I met my stepmom. And you know something? My stepmother, we get along so well. She calls me all the time and texts me. She calls the kids. Wow, how are the kids, April? I love you so much. I miss you. I call her mom. I love you so much. I missed my grandkids. When you gonna come? We gonna come see you because I know it's too much money for you and the kids, all the kids on the plane. We come see you. We can come in next month. You know, me and her was on the phone a few days ago for like an hour and a half. Me and my dad, after I hung up with her, me and my dad were on the phone for like 2 hours. When I call my own biological mother, she give me like 10-15 minutes of her time, and she'll talk about her friends from work and so forth. And then when it gets onto the subject about how I'm doing or what I've been doing, well, April, I gotta go right now. I'm busy. You weren't busy for that 10-15 minutes talking to me about your fucking job and friends. And now when I want to tell you about my life, you too fucking busy? Like, who does that? Where do we do that the fuck at? So here's the thing, sweetheart. Don't let your mom get in the way of your relationship with your father. She has her own bitterness and has her own resentment to him. Don't let her pull you down about how you feel about him. If he wants to be the hero now, then go ahead and let him be the hero now. And it shouldn't have to be about financial. Do it and stay with your dad and your stepmom because this is what you want to do. And I think that this would be great for you. It'll help you save money, but it'll also help you build a relationship with your dad and your stepmother. And if you two get along well, then why not? Sometimes we all got to grow up in life. I don't really give a fuck if my kids have a stepmother. As long as you don't be a disrespectful bitch to my kids, then I could care less. But some people, when they're old school, they're just set in their ways. And my mom is one of them. I love my stepmother to the pieces, okay? She's so concerned. She calls all the time. She knows when all of my kids' birthdays are. She knows all my kids' names. And unfortunately, my mom does not. And I don't really know why. And I say this because my mom has texted me and said, "Can you text me the kid's name and birthday?" This was last year. Okay? She does favor my oldest son more, and I've had to tell her, if you can't send the rest of the kids stuff, then don't send anybody anything. Because I don't think it's right. And I never say anything about my mother to the kids because they automatically think that she doesn't really care for them. Which is fucked up because they see her always, or used to always send Jerron my oldest son stuff. And she would never send my other kids anything. Or she would send him expensive gifts and they would get like a coloring book and things like that. And my kids just noticed that on their own. So I had to cut that out, nip that in the bud. Like, if you're not going to send them anything, don't send anybody anything. Don't just send Jerron stuff and don't send them nothing. You know, kids have a feeling about shit. They have their own feelings. But, okay, your mom, she's bitter, and that's just what it is. Your dad and you have a relationship. That's your father. Regardless of how that relationship ended, that's not your business and that's not your place. You know what I'm saying? That's their business and that's their place. And you need to stay in a child's place. Though you're grown, you still need to stay in your own place and be supportive to both your parents. But don't take sides. You know what I'm saying? Because it's hard. Like, I don't never tell my mom, my dad calls me and I call him. I call my dad like every week, all the time. His wife will call me all the time. He'll call me all the time. And unfortunately, I don't get that with my mom. She doesn't call. She don't call for the holidays. Like, I always have to call her. And, like, I call her on Christmas. Well, I'm sleeping right now. Like, it's Christmas. Okay, I get it, but on Thanksgiving, well, I'm taking a nap right now. Like, all right, do you like me or not? Or do you really not want to hear from me? So, certain shit that that goes on in my life, she don't know nothing about. She don't know nothing about me and my son, father, back together. She don't know nothing about that. She don't know a lot of things about me because it's like what even bothers. And I'm not trying to be disrespectful to her, but at a point in your life, you get tired of the shit. And it's like, you know what? Grow the fuck up. I'm not going to allow you to keep dogging me out and making me feel some type of way. If you don't want to be bothered, then you don't want to be fucking bothered. Regardless of who you are to me. I'm not going to bow down and kiss your ass because you're my parent. It is a mutual respect. So, my dear, I'm going to say this. Go and live with your father and build a relationship with him and your stepmother. It's natural. And it's your birthright. And it's your right. And unfortunately, your mom is going to feel that way. And I will tell you like this. She'll get over it. She has no choice but to get the fuck over it. And if she don't, you know what you need to let her know? Why are you trying to turn me against him? Because you're so bitter towards him doesn't mean that I have to be. What you two had going on is not my concern. I'm not involved in your divorce. I'm a child. That's my father. You're my mother. I love you both the same. We all make mistakes and I understand how you feel, but I cannot choose because it's not morally. It's not right. And let her know this. But me personally, I say go for it. Get to know your stepmother because trust me, honey, even though she might have been the cause for the divorce, she isn't 100% the cause for the divorce because your father played a role in this too. And your mom might have played a role in it as well that you just don't know about. But just because he married her doesn't mean she's a bad person. You know what I'm saying? And like you said, y'all two clicked. And your mom, of course, she's going to be mad about that. Come on now. You think mine's ain't? But I love my stepmother to pieces. Like, for real. For realsies, I love that lady. Norma is the best stepmother I've ever had. And when I say ever had, like, trust me, bitches, she's my third one, okay? I had Betty. She got a son with my dad. She ended up being a crackhead and turned into a crackhead. And then I got Sandy, who ended up being, she's white. She ended up being a slut. And then I have Norma, who is Filipino. So my mom was the only black woman. But you guys already know I'm not fully black. But either way, nor here nor there, I love Norma to pieces. And he's the best thing my dad has ever married and has met. She's a wonderful person. And we click like that. So give her a chance and go ahead and move in with your dad. He's offering you a stability. Why not take it and be a family? Because it gets lonely sometimes being alone, bitch. For real. So on that note, I know this video has been super duper long. I probably done talked you girls' ears off. And y'all probably like, girl, please shut the fuck up already. But either way, whatever. Stay tuned. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe. Leave your comments below. Let these young ladies know what you would do in this situation. And I will see y'all all in the next video. Bye.